Hey guys, RPD Dueling here, bringing you another deck profile. This is another mono faction profile from the faction tournament that we did a little while ago. This time we are going to be looking at mono Haos. On this team, the Bakugan that we chose to use were Haos Fangzor, Haos Picatrix, and Haos Garganoid Ultra. Fangzor has a 100 B power and 7 damage rating. He also holds Inherent Domination if your Bakugan holds the most Baku cores, plus 400 B power. Pegatrix has 500 B power and 2 damage rating. If she lands on a green fist, it gets plus 200 B and plus 2 damage rating. And then Garganoid Ultra has 400 B power and 3 damage rating. The cores that we're using on these, a shield for Fangzor is a shield that has Haos Ventus gets 400 B. The green one is a plus 100 B, and then Pyrus Haos gets plus 3 damage. Pegatrix has a green fist that gives plus 150 and plus 2, and then a plus 100, and then Pyrus Haos gets plus 3. And then Garganoid has a shield. Haos Pyrus gets plus 400. And then a green fist of 150 plus 2 damage. So let's jump right into the cards here. Start with the Evos. We run 2 Diamond Pegatrix. It's a 6 cost card. Boosts her up to 1200 B power and 6 damage. And then 1 Titan Pegatrix. It's a 4 energy cost. Boosts her up to 1000. And 4 damage. If she hits a green fist, it's 500 B and plus 5 damage. Then we are looking at 2 Hyper Fangzors. Takes him up to 600 B power and 8 damage. And then he has domination if your Bakugan are holding the most cores, plus 900. Then we run 2 copies of Hyper Garganoid Ultra. 700 B power and 5 damage. If you have 3 or more heroes in play, he gets plus 500 B and 5 damage rating. Into the ability cards, action cards here. We run at 0 energy cost, 2 copies of Whiteout. It's plus 3 damage to a Haos Bakugan. Obviously, this is a mono deck. It'll work for any of them. Then at 1 energy cost, we run 2 copies of the Sky's Hymn. You get to look at the top 3 cards of your deck and put them on top of your deck in any order. And then if you have domination, if your Bakugan have the most cores, you also get to draw a card. Basically, you look at the top 3 cards of your deck. If you do have the most cores, you get to take, you just pick the one you want to draw. Then we have 1 copy of Cycling Light, plus 200 B power, and then it goes to the bottom of your deck. So pretty much you get plus 200 B and then heal 1. So pretty decent there. We run 2 copies, now we're in our 2 energy cost cards, 2 copies of Wayne. This destroys an Evo that was not played this turn. So a great card to disrupt your opponent with. Evos, though not as prominent as heroes, I don't believe, still can make a difference in the battle. So being able to take them out is always a good thing. After that, we're going to run 1 copy of Surge of Light. You get plus 4 damage rating. 1 copy of Stoic Shot. Draw a card, and it also has domination. You get to draw 2 cards if you're dominating. Then we run Thunder Sword. You get plus 2 Frost Strike. This is one of those that probably won't see much play. I didn't really base the deck on Frost Strike. I can see where Frost Strike would be helpful. This makes it to where the flip cards your opponent plays cost whatever that is more, so that would be plus 2. Their flips would cost plus 2 to play. I can see where that would be helpful to stop them from defending, But I did not build the deck around that, so I don't really have very much of it going on. But there, I may at some point build a deck just around that. Going on to our three cost cards, three copies of Bone Defense. It's a plus 700 B power for three. It's a pretty good deal. Then three copies of Consort. Haos is all about domination, holding the most Baku cores. Consort allows you to attach a core from the field to an open Bakugan, so pretty much you're gaining cores. It also helps with team attacks too. Going on to our four energy cards, we have two copies of Luminous Armor. This adds 900 to a Haos Bakugan. It's a mono deck, all three of them are Haos, so it will always work. Onto our five cost cards, two copies of Dream Illusion. Five energy cost, you get 1100 B power, so that's not terrible. It is a fairly high costed card, but the payout's pretty good. So if you can play it, it is worth it. Then we have at six energy cost, one copy of Beaming Blaster. This is a plus six damage rating, but if you're dominating, you get plus 12 instead. And then a Wing Cutter, plus 600, and if you are dominating, this card comes back to your hand, you'd be able to use it next turn for another 600, and so on and so forth. So that recycle thing, that's really cool. So that's it for the actual action cards. Now let's look at our heroes. We are running two copies of Veronica Venegas. It's domination. If your Bakugan are holding the most cores, you get plus 3 to your attacks. So it's a pretty basic effect for Haos. The deck's more based around domination. So you would hope that her ability would always come through. Then we have Colonel Armstrong Trip. When one of your Bakugan attacks, draw a card. Pretty basic, pretty straightforward card there. And a D. Your Bakugan have plus one Frost Strike. Just an inherent little thing. I believe that pretty much I ran D to be able to have four heroes, because I think Garganoid has an effect that if you have three or more, you get plus 500 on him, so I tried to have more. I didn't want to run Leah. The 10 cost seemed a little steep for what she does. So I ran with those instead. Then that's it for the heroes. On to our flip cards. At two cost, we have Heroic Inspiration. You get to draw a card for each hero you have in play. This goes hand in hand with the Garganoid, and I see there being a separate deck for that kind of play style, with Leah and Garganoid and Heroic Inspiration. And then two copies of Halt Outsiders. If you've watched any of my other deck profiles, you'll know that I love the Outsider cards. Usually I run three. I think I only have two copies of Halt Outsiders. It's no big deal, because Haos has a lot of other stop damage flip cards. Then we're running two copies of Luck Aura. This lets you play a card from your hand for free. This would probably be the way to get your Titans out, your Titan Pegatrix, and your higher level cards. Then we have two copies of Stand Together. It stops non-Haos damage, but it also has a domination effect. If your Bakugan are holding the most cores, this card is free. So this actually has the capacity to be better than the Outsider card. And then also one copy of Haos Ascendancy, which stops non-Haos, and then this card comes to your hand. I would probably just play it as energy next turn. Free energy. You don't have to think. But that's going to be it for the Haos build. Haos was a semi-finalist in the faction tournament. The finals was Haos versus Ventus. And Ventus just ramps. it ramps energy, and then it plays the cards, and it can just play everything all at once, and you can't, it's hard. It's hard to beat that. And again, like I said, in all the mono faction deck profiles so far, is I am working with what I have, and I'm also, these decks were the ones used in that tournament. I was utilizing that tournament as a way to figure out how each faction stood on its own, what its weaknesses were, what its strengths were, what maybe their abilities that they have that might meld together, play with different play styles within each deck. Like this one, I have the hero thing and the domination thing, just to see how everything worked out. Now that we've done the faction tournament, we've done a little bit of research when we're getting better at the game, I'm going to start actually deck building, and we'll probably have realistic deck profiles out. And not so much realistic, but actual deck profiles out for probably what we're going to be wanting to use at tournaments. But thank you for watching. If you like this content, like and subscribe. If you have anything to say about the deck, any ideas or critiques or anything, post it down in the comments. And as always, y'all take it easy.